How to use Microsoft Teams for iPad. In this tutorial, I will show you how to install Microsoft Teams, invite members, start a chat, start a call, and also do a group call. I will show you also how to manage calls and schedule meeting on Microsoft Teams on the iPad. Let's get started. How to install and create account on Microsoft Teams for iPad. Microsoft Teams is a persistent chat-based collaboration platform completely with document sharing, online meetings, and many more extremely useful features for business communications. Microsoft Teams has many core components that make it stand out from other collaboration software. Teams and channels, conversation within channels and teams, a chat function, document storage in SharePoint, online video calling and screen sharing, online meetings, audio conference. How do you install Microsoft Teams on iPad? First of all, go to the App Store. Tap on the search. Write Microsoft Teams on the search. After you have found the app, tap Get. Use your fingerprint, Face ID, or password to accept the install. After the install is done, just tap on Open. On this new page, click on Sign up for free if you want to create an account. You can use Microsoft Teams for free and you can use it with any account. Tap on Sign in with another account, but you can also create one. If you want to create an account, you can select for what you wish to use Teams. You can choose personal or work. Enter an email you wish to use for your Teams account. Click on Sign in. Microsoft found that I already have an account on their service, so I will need to write the password. If you did not create a Microsoft account, you would be asked to configure a password and share some info about yourself, like country, birthday, and also confirm your email. Click Sign in. Now, you can select a team or your personal account. If you choose personal, it might ask you for a phone number. Write your phone number and tap Next. Microsoft sent a code to your phone. Write it and then tap Next. Now select again Personal. Tap Allow Teams to send notification. Tap Continue. Tap Continue. Tap OK for Teams to access contacts. Tap here what you want. You have now created an account on Teams for Microsoft on iPad. You can now start organizing your company and work on Teams. How to create a team on Microsoft Teams for iPad? You can use Microsoft Teams for a personal account and for business. If you create a personal account, you will not be able to create a team, but you will be able to invite other persons. To check if you have a personal account or a business account, you can see the bottom taskbar. If you have the Teams button, then it means you have a business account. From what you see now, I have here a personal account. Let's switch to the business account. To create a new team, tap on the Teams button. Tap on the plus button from the top. Tap the Create a new team button. Write the team name. Only letters, numbers, and spaces are allowed. You can also write a description. On privacy, you can set up the theme to be public or private. If you set this to be public, then anyone in your team can join and add other members. If you set up it as private, then only team owners can send invites. Set up this how you like and tap on the back arrow. Tap Done to create the team. You can now add members to the team on iPad. You can enter the name or the email of a person. After you have added a member, just tap on the Done button from the top. Now the team has been created. Please note, sometimes it takes a bit of time for the team to appear. This is how you create a team on your iPad for Microsoft Teams. How to invite members on Microsoft Teams for iPad? To invite a new member to the team, you need to open the Teams app on your iPad. Tap on the Teams button from the bottom. On every team, you have three dots near the name. Tap on those three dots. If you are not the owner of a team, you will be able only to view members, like I see for this team. Let's tap on the Other Teams three dots menu. You see here an option called Manage Members. Tap it. Plus button to add a new team member. Tap it. Write the email for your team member. You can invite a person as a member of the team. Tap Done. An invitation will be sent to the person's email. This is how you send an invitation to your team on Microsoft Teams for iPad. How to create a private channel on Microsoft Teams for iPad? Private channel in Microsoft Teams create focused space for collaboration within your teams. Only the user of the team who are the owners or members of the private channel can access the channel. Anyone, including guests, can be added as a member of a private channel as long as they are already members of the team. You might want to use a private channel if you want to limit collaboration to those who have a need to know or if you want to facilitate communication between a group of people assigned to a specific project without having to create an additional team to manage. For example, a private channel is useful in these scenarios. A group of people in a team wants a focused space to collaborate without creating a separate team. A subset of people in a team wants a private channel to discuss sensitive information, such as budgets, resourcing, strategic positioning. To create a private channel on iPad, tap on the Teams button from the bottom. Here, tap on the three dots menu near the name of the team. On the menu, tap on Manage Channels. You can only manage channels where you are the owner. Tap on the plus Add Channel button from the top on iPad. Write the name of the channel. Write the description of the channel. On privacy, you need to select the option Private, only accessible to a specific group of people within the team. The standard version is open to everyone on the team. Now tap on the back button. Tap on the Done button. On this new page, add the person you wish to have access to this channel. You can add either some team members or add a new email. After this, click on Done. It can take a bit of time for the channel to appear. You see that on the new private channel, you have a lock on it. This means the channel is not available for everyone. On a channel, you can write messages, send attachment, files, images, and even videos. Also, you can add different tabs and collaborate on projects. This is how you add channels to your iPad on Microsoft Teams for iPad. How to start chat on Microsoft Teams for iPad? chat is at the center of whatever you do in Teams, from individual chats with just one other person to group chats and conversation in channels. Chat has you covered. Sometimes you'll want to talk one-on-one with somebody. Other times you'll want to have a small group chat. In chat you can do either. For you to start the chat, tap on the chat tab from the bottom. On this window, you will have our recent chats. Also, you will have a filter option that we can use. On the top, we have an invite people option. To start the chat with somebody, click on the new chat button from the top. On the top part, you can enter a name, email, group, or tag to start the conversation. Also, you can tap on a person name. When I add the text, the system automatically tries to find the person. After you found the person, click it. You have now started the chat with the person on your iPad. Once in a chat, you will be able to send messages that include files, links, emojis, stickers, and GIFs. Whatever you need to get your point across. I advise you to look at every option and see what you can use for yourself. This is how you start a chat on Microsoft Teams from your iPad. How to group call on Microsoft Teams for iPad. Microsoft Teams offers many impressive and valuable video conference features. Users can host full HD calls with up to 250 members, which includes the ability to share screen and record calls. Users can also host or collaborate on the go using Microsoft Teams apps for smartphones and tablets. Video calling is an essential tool in the modern workplace since employers are more frequently working remotely or from various office locations. Using Microsoft Teams, employers can quickly meet virtually, discuss, brainstorm, and work on documents in real time. To start a call on iPad, just click on the More button from the bottom. Tap on Calls. If you have the Calls button on the bottom, then you can simply tap it. Tap on the plus button from the top on iPad. Now you can make a call. Just write the person name or email. On the directory, you will be able to do an audio and video call. You can add multiple persons. Now tap on the call button. You can start also a group call from the chat tab. If you already have a group, just click it. On the top right, you have two buttons, a video call button and an audio call button. You can also start a group call on the channels. Tap on Teams. Now tap on the channel from a team. On the top, we have a call button. Tap on that. A new call has started now. You can now start a new meeting. The system is pretty nice and I love the design. On the call, you will have a button to start and stop the video. You can put audio here on mute. You can share the screen on an iPad. You can share a PowerPoint, photo, video, and screen. Also, another button is Raise Hand. You can show the organizer of the meeting you wish to say something. You have started the call now on your iPad. You can try to use these features to be used to it. How to start meeting on Microsoft Teams for iPad? Meetings in Teams include audio, video, and sharing. In Teams, there are two ways to initiate a real-time communication. A user can call another user directly, or a user can create a meeting. For calls, the media travel as directly as possible. If, for example, there's no firewall between two users, media traffic travels directly from one user to the other. If a firewall blocks direct traffic between the users, the traffic will be sent via a relay. To start a meeting on Microsoft Teams for iPad, tap on the Meetings. Now tap on the New Meeting button from the top. Write the title of the meeting. Select the start date and the end date for the meeting. If you want to start the meeting now, just leave the date like that. Tap the Done button. Now tap the Join button to start the meeting. A meeting is now starting. You can enable or disable audio and video. To start the meeting, click Join Now. From the start, you will be able to invite person to this meeting, and the Participant button will show you the current person in the meeting, and you will be able to invite somebody else to the call. The chat button will open the conversation. On the call, you can share the screen with this button. On Raise Hand, you can show the organizer of the meeting you wish to say something. On the call, you will have a button to start and stop the video. You can put audio here on mute. On the three dots menu, you can put the meeting on hold and turn off the incoming video. This is how you start the meeting on Microsoft Teams on iPad. How to share screen on Microsoft Teams for iPad. One of the important features of Microsoft Teams is the share of a screen. Even if you have Microsoft Teams on your iPad, you can still share the screen. To share screen on your iPad, first you will need to open the Teams app. After that, you need to start a new meeting. You can create a new meeting by going to the chat and calling somebody or a group. Also, you can start a meeting on the Meeting tab. Let me start a call. To start a screen share on Microsoft Teams on iPad, tap on the Share button. You can share a photo, a video, SharePoint, and share a screen. Let's select the Share screen. To start screen sharing, tap on Start Broadcasting. The screen sharing is started. After this, you can end the share of the screen by tapping Stop Presenting from the Teams app. For me, it seems that there was an error on the iPad and this did not work well. So I had to stop the screen sharing from the Control Center. How to schedule meeting on Microsoft Teams for iPad? To schedule a meeting, open Microsoft Teams on iPad. If you wish to schedule a meeting on Microsoft Teams, you have to go to the Meetings tab. Here, you have the possibility to start a meeting right away or schedule a meeting. Let's click on the Add Meeting button from the top. Write the title of the meeting. Select the start date and end date for the meeting. Tap Done button on your iPad. Here, you can copy the meeting invitation and send it by any message app or email, or share it via Google Calendar. You can now copy the link and send the invitation on any app like WhatsApp or Facebook. Also, you can tap on Meeting Options. You can set up some of the meeting option if you want. After you finish this, just tap on Save. You have now scheduled a meeting on Teams on iPad. If this was useful, please like, share and subscribe. You can also watch more videos from the right. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them in the comments area below.